So now I'll be talking to you about petty cash. What is petty cash? A petty cash fund is a small amount of cash kept on hand to pay for minor expenses such as office supplies or reimbursements. A petty cash fund will undergo periodic reconciliations with transactions also recorded on the financial statements. So there might be a petty cash fund which can be a drawer or a box in each department for larger corporations. Now there are some things that we should note here, like the petty cash or the petty cash fund is a small amount of cash on hand used for paying expenses that are too small to or can be merited to writing a check. There might be a petty cash drawer or a box in each department for larger corporations. A petty cash fund can be used for office supplies, cards for customers, and many other things. Now, where is this petty cash used? For that, we need to understand what petty cash is. So, petty cash transactions provide a convenience for small transactions for which issuing a check is unreasonable or unacceptable. The small amount of cash that a company considers petty will vary, with many companies keeping between around $50 to $200 as petty cash fund. Examples of transactions that a petty cash fund can include office supplies, or cards for customers, flowers, paying for a catered lunch for a small group of employees, or reimbursing an employee for small work-related expenses. So, petty cash fund custodians are appointed to oversee this fund. The custodian duties generally include enforcing petty cash rules and regulations, requesting replenishments, and dispersing the funds. Now, there are some special considerations that we need to look upon. The petty cash fund is reconciled periodically to verify that the balance of the fund is correct. Typically, as the petty cash balance falls to a preset level, the custodian applies for additional cash from the cashier. At this time, the total of all the receipts is calculated to ensure that it matches the disbursed funds from the petty cash drawer. If new funds are needed, the cashier will write a new check to fund the petty cash drawer and takes in exchange the receipts from purchases that depleted the cash. The reconciliation process ensures that the fund's remaining balance equals the difference between the original balance minus the charges detailed on the receipt and all the invoices. If the remaining balance is less than what it should be, there is a shortage. If the remaining balance is more than what it should be, there is a overage. So, although there can be minor variances, when unbalanced, the source of the discrepancy should be identified and corrected. Now, the requirements for petty cash. The use of petty cash fund circumvents certain internal controls. The availability of petty cash does not mean that it can be accessed for any purpose and by anyone. Many companies employ strict internal controls to manage the fund, and often limited individuals are authorized to approve disbursements and can only do so for expense related to legitimate company activities or operations. A petty cashier might be assigned to issue the check to fund the petty cash drawer and make the appropriate accounting entries. The petty cash custodian is charged with distributing the cash and collecting receipts for all purchases or any uses of the fund. As the petty cash total declines, the receipt should increase and tie out the total amount withdrawn. By having a petty cash cashier and a petty cash custodian, the dual process helps to keep the fund secure and ensure that only the authorized have access to it. Now, how to record petty cash? When petty cash funds is in use, petty cash transactions are still recorded in the financial statements of the company. No accounting journal entries are made when purchases are made using petty cash. It's only when the custodian needs more cash and in exchange for the receipt receives new funds that the journal entries are recorded. The journal entry for giving the custodian more cash is a debit to the petty cash fund and a credit to cash. If there's a shortage or overage, a journal line entry is recorded to an or short account. If the petty cash fund is over, a credit is entered to represent a gain. If the petty cash fund is short, a debit is entered to represent a loss. The over or short account is used to force balance the fund upon reconciliation.